Matt, over to you.
Okay, thank you. And now to that late breaking development on the tornado outbreak. Woodward's emergency manager Matt Leenbauer just confirmed a 6th person has died. 3 of those were children. Today we'll get a better look at the tornado damage in western Oklahoma. You're looking at some of it right here on your screen. FEMA and state leaders will begin touring the destruction in Woodward. Governor Mary Fallon has declared a disaster emergency for 12 counties. Nearly 100 homes in Woodward have damage. And this morning we're learning more about the people who have died in this weekend storms.
Yeah, KOCL's Dan Thomas starts our team coverage in Woodward. Good morning, Dan. What do you know about this 6th person that died?
Guys, we're working to find out more information about that person right now. We'll, of course, bring it to you as soon as we have it. But as for the other 5, it appears that in each of those cases, it involved parents trying to get to a shelter with their very young children. And I did travel to the Hideaway Mobile Home Park. That's where 3 people died. Father Frank Hobby and his 3 children lived there. Frank and his 2 daughters are among the confirmed dead. They were 5 and 7 years old. His young son last listed in critical condition. I talked to one woman who lived next door to the family. She saw the kids playing all the time and is in total shock knowing that she'll never see them again. Like many people in that neighborhood, her home is destroyed as well.
I don't know. I don't know which direction my trailer went.
I have a drawer with all my birth certificate, my ID, everything. I have absolutely nothing.
And we do know the name of one other victim, Darren Jewell. He's an adult male, died alongside a 10-year-old girl who is very likely his daughter. They died when the tornado struck just about southwest of town here in the Tangier area. That was early on in the debris path that hit here in Woodward. Reporting live in Woodward, Dan Thomas, KOCL.